Nick, I'm actually pretty excited about this subject that we're talking about, automotive and robotics, because we have to talk about robotics almost every video now.
But they're interrelated. If you are excited about robotaxis in 2026, autonomous vehicles, there is definitely some overlap with developments in industrial IoT and even humanoid robots. And we're going to talk about a company that we haven't talked about for quite some time now, Mobileye.
I feel like we're going back to our roots a little bit. We haven't been able to talk about automotive very much in the last couple of years because it's been in such of a downturn, but here we are. I'm really happy to be back talking about mobile. In market there at the bottom, auto and industrial, of course, robotics would fit into this industrial section. And that's kind of where we're encouraging everybody to focus on is industrial robotics. It's exciting to talk about humanoid robotics, but really, industrial is where we can focus a lot of our attention because humanoid robotics are not going to be mainstream for quite some time. But one example of industrial robotics is, of course, Intuitive Surgical, a surgical robot, which is pretty awesome.
And generates revenue. There's the whole industrial side, which we talked about a number of times, even last month. And we'll come back to that. But let's focus on automotive because that is the consumer-facing part of the industry right now. Humanoid robots is a ways off. And we're going to talk about the three leaders in our assessment, the three growth leaders, and they all happen to be fabless. The IDMs in particular, Infineon, as well as Europe's other IDMs like STMicro, NXP, Bosch, Microchip in the US, and then Renesas in Japan, and some of the IDMs there in East Asia. Still the beginnings of a slow recovery. But the ones that have really kind of bucked the trend are, of course, Nvidia and Qualcomm. We'll start there. And then we're going to come back to Mobileye here because some interesting things have happened just this week with Mobileye.
If you're wondering what ECU is, that's electronic control unit. There's multiple on a car. They control the transmission system or EAS system.
It's the car's computer. This slide here from our friends over at fiscal.ai. We're going to start with Mobileye showing their quarterly revenue. Those are the orange bars in green. The little green bars is the free cash flow. And then the cash on balance, over $1.7 billion. We're going to come back to this again a little bit later and talk about revenue and free cash flow on a trailing 12-month basis and talk about Mobileye's finally bit of a recovery in automotive sales. But shout out here to fiscal.ai, really fantastic platform where you can get all the data you need to directly analyze businesses and get the source for that data all directly within their platform. Really great set of tools for analyzing businesses and industries.
And Fiscal has aggressively decreased their pricing. So make sure you check it out. You can get an additional 15% off any paid plan with the link here in the video or in the description below, fiscal.ai/CSI. Check it out right now.
So you can see it's been a sluggish recovery since they bottomed in the March 2024 quarter. Well over $1.7 billion in cash on balance and no debt. Hold that in your memory bank. Let's talk about Nvidia and Qualcomm automotive revenue because these two companies are doing a lot of work in self-driving cars, advanced driver assist systems, and you can see they kind of largely bucked the downtrend for this semiconductor end market segment. They had a little bit of a blip there in 2023, but very quickly returned to growth and both of these segments at all-time high sales for both companies. Let's continue with Nvidia's automotive specifically.
If you're looking for a bet on both auto and robotics, the problem with NVIDIA is the vast majority of the revenue is tied to data centers. You can see Nick has auto highlighted there, up 32% year-over-year growth in the latest quarter, but still just pittance in compared to what the data center revenue is. Of course, there is some of that revenue coming from companies training their AI systems for robotics or any of their other systems, but for the actual hardware itself, very small portion of the pie.
So that's the problem with Nvidia specifically, if you're looking for a bet on automotive robotics and industrial or humanoid robotics. But there are some things happening here. It is still a part of the business and it's not completely useless because Nvidia is doing some work here to try to make this segment larger. And earlier in 2025, they announced the Nvidia Drive AGX Thor developer kits were available. And so these are for automotive companies, either startups or legacy auto companies that are trying to get more advanced driver assist and self-driving capabilities into their cars so they could buy these things and start working on implementation of self-driving features within the car itself. But let's talk about the more recent happenings this week at CES in Las Vegas.
NVIDIA announced Alpamayo family of AI models for autonomous vehicle development. This obviously marks a bigger push into the software pipeline for autos with open AI models for developers. So even more efforts into this.
You made the point, Casey, a lot of the data center revenue isn't just data center infrastructure. A lot of that infrastructure being used by automotive companies, auto startups, training AI models. So it's really hard to separate the two from each other and say, this is just siloed data center revenue for NVIDIA, but we don't get that breakdown. So what this does mean though, similar to a few weeks ago when NVIDIA announced the release of the Nemotron family of open AI models, they are increasing that full stack compute for these end markets, not just the hardware itself, but really leaning into the software side to try to help developers speed up their system development. So interesting to see this here from NVIDIA, and obviously adoption of this would be nothing but good for the company and shareholders as we're looking for a bit of diversification away from the main hyperscaler customers.
All right, let's switch to Qualcomm, which had a similar story in automotive. Automotive has actually been their fastest growing segment in recent years, and it's now almost 10% of their total revenue. So significant improvement. We have that highlighted. Q4 fiscal year 2025, just over $1 billion, up 17% year over year. This number is much bigger than NVIDIA's automotive portion because it's not just advanced driver assist systems and autonomy. They also do those ECUs or electronic control units that control vehicle connectivity as well as the infotainment systems.
So not an apples to apples comparison with NVIDIA, which is fully focused on ADAS and autonomy. But nevertheless, Qualcomm, regardless of what you may think about the company, kind of a more boring, sleepy semiconductor business, handsets, aka smartphones, still the biggest revenue segment. And the good news there, it is also back in growth mode again, pretty good 14% year-over-year revenue growth there in the last quarter. But the other portion of the business that's maybe related to automotive robotics would be the IoT segment, as Qualcomm has been doing a lot of work itself in industrial IoT and industrial robotics. They also had some announcements at CES as they're starting to do some development work also on humanoid robots. But nevertheless, that's further on down the road. Right now, this is very much a smartphone and automotive company.
Okay. So now let's talk about Mobileye.
This is where things get exciting. But later on, everybody's going to fast forward to this section of the presentation, I have a feeling.
Yeah, I feel like we might be building it up a bit.
No, it's cool stuff. This is not the same slide as earlier. This is actually quarterly revenue for Mobileye in orange and free cash flow in green on a trailing 12-month basis. It basically just smooths out the results a little bit. They have been recovering, as you can see from the downturn. They bottomed in 2024. But it's still not that nice V-shaped radical reemergence of growth yet. Maybe that's coming this year. But the thing that we want to focus on here is the cash. As Casey mentioned earlier, well over $1.7 billion in cash. They made their own big announcement at CES in Las Vegas this week. What is it? What did they do?
They spent $900 million on an acquisition. of the startup Mentee Robotics.
So, to many of you have been wondering, why isn't there more US-based humanoid robot plays? Other than Tesla, of course. Now you have another one, Mobileye. In Asia, you have lots of them. In China has a lot of publicly traded humanoid robot development companies. Japan, South Korea, actually last month in December, we talked about Hyundai Motor Group and called out the majority stake that they have in Boston Dynamics. That was by design that we mentioned that. At CES, Boston Dynamics had some notable announcements that sent Hyundai's stock higher. So there's stuff going on here. And now more US companies are getting in on this race. Mentee is a startup though. So we need to curb some enthusiasm here, but let's talk about what Mobileye first brings to the table and then what Mentee brings to the table and why this is maybe a compelling small basket bet.
There's some overlap here. They've been working on basically vehicle robotics, hardware and software. And while a robotic car is maybe not exactly the same thing or the same challenges as a humanoid robot, there is definitely some development overlap here. So that's what Mobileye is bringing to the table. Lots of experience in developing robotics for especially robot cars.
The robotization of the vehicle is now overlapping with humanoid robots. Mentee, they do a lot of stuff in-house, including the chips, the brains of the computer. They do a lot of work on the sensors, the actuators. An actuator converts the energy flowing through the robot into motion. You think of it like the joints of the robot. And they tout here having 40 degrees of freedom, so 40 different joints on the Mentee robot. They also do software development. They've been working on interaction through voice. So obviously there would be some LLM development here in-house. And so they're going to be merging this with what Mobileye has to offer as well, which is work on processors, sensor fusion, and all the work that they do in vehicles, making also work on a robot as well. So let's take a look at Mobileye's current revenue, because even once this acquisition is complete, do not expect to see this big increase in sales because of the addition of Mentee. This is mostly like IP and R&D work that they're acquiring. Mobileye is still very much going to be an automotive technologist. And so these are some of the key performance indicators that you would want to watch that are actually going to move the stock for the foreseeable future.
Yeah, IQ and supervision revenue. That's the blue bar. IQ is the system on chip. And supervision is the whole system, including sensors and software.
Yeah, and the yellow line there from fiscal on their KPI, 9.2 million systems shipped in Q3 of 2025. So they're still off their peak, but making progress towards recovery, their last peak back in 2023 for total systems shipped. The sluggish recovery is why the stock is still down. It's been not a very exciting business the last few years. We should mention also here, Intel still owns 80% of Mobileye equity. So if you happen to own Intel, you already have a stake in Mobileye. But it does seem like Intel is continuously divesting itself of this. They had the follow-on sale of equity 7 months ago. We expect that may continue. So Mobileye is interesting. I guess basically what we're doing here is we're calling this out as a company of interest right now, in part because of the acquisition of Mentee, also because if we do get a more robust recovery in the automotive and industrial segment in 2026, Mobileye would be a potential beneficiary of that recovery. We pulled this from Nvidia because they have this very robust pipeline. We're going back now to the automotive segment here in particular. And again, there's going to be some overlap with this. Obviously not the same problem, but similar. Here are some companies that you might consider as a small cap, little mini index in automotive robotics. And you can look for some overlap in these companies with the humanoid robot development. But right now, the companies actually generating revenue are going to be in the automotive robotics, self-driving car part of the semi industry, not so much the actual humanoid robots. So check out the Chipstock Investor Research platform. We will be putting these companies as well as robotics companies in there. And don't forget fiscal.ai, fantastic place to get all the financial data you need in one place to analyze businesses. And Casey already mentioned that they have decreased their pricing across the board for individual investors, plus the additional 15% off. If you use our link, make sure to check it out.
See you all again soon at Chick Stock Investor.